Welcome back to the Sixth Gear Garage. Today, I also had to adjust the valves on my 2007 Honda Fit. A couple parts to get before I start. Here I have a Felpro valve cover kit, and it comes with new rubber grommets and the valve cover gasket. And a Felpro gasket kit for the intake manifold. This metal one is for the lower intake and the head, so I won't need that. These go between the upper and lower intakes, so I'll use those. And it also includes this throttle body gasket, which I need. I found these on Amazon, and I'll put links to both of these in the description. First, get the car on jack stands and remove the front right wheel. And that gives me access to the crank pulley bolt behind this cover. Come on around to the engine, and I'm already missing the plastic engine cover. Some say to remove the lower intake. No thanks. Valves can be done with just removing the plastic upper intake. First, I removed the air intake. This cheap intake came in my car instead of the OEM airbox. If anyone has a spare OEM airbox, I'd love to buy it. Regardless of which intake I have, there's so much more room to work now. Next, I'm going to unbolt the throttle body from the upper intake manifold by loosening these four large bolts. Don't forget this piece. It has the nuts on the back. If so, it can fall down in the engine bay. And there's one on the back side as well. On top of the manifold here, unplug this sensor. Then remove two bolts attaching this bracket to the intake manifold and this hose. Next, remove the five 12 millimeter bolts that connect the plastic upper manifold to the aluminum lower manifold. This bracket has the nuts attached to the back. Set it aside. And there's a bracket for the two lower bolts as well. Now the manifold can be removed. Psych. I forgot this 10 millimeter bolt back here. Now I can remove the intake manifold. And right here on this back corner is where that last 10 millimeter bolt was. Now we've uncovered the valve cover. I taped over everything and blew all the dirt off. Now I get to remove one, two, three, four. Hopefully yours has bolt number five there. Wow, holy shit, six is gone too. And seven, that one looks brand new. So it looks like someone was in here before and lost some bolts. I had to unbolt one additional bracket in order to make enough room to remove the valve cover from the head. Here's one more bolt that I had to remove from the back of the cylinder head that held on this bracket. By the way, the engine should be cool when doing this or barely warm. Definitely not hot. Take a look at the cam sprocket here. I need to be at top dead center to begin. Right here you can see the letters UP. That needs to be facing up for top dead center. So let's go into the wheel well. Move these little arrows in out of the way. And you can see the crank pulley bolt in there. Grab a 19 millimeter socket. And the hole in the liner doesn't exactly line up with the bolt. Well, plan B. Remove the splash shield from the body and access. There we go. Not sure why that's like an inch off. Grab a couple long extensions so it sticks out like this. Perfect. Now I'm just turning the crank a little bit clockwise until that up is right about there. I've got the old feeler gauges here, and these are in inches, so 0.006 to 0.007 for the intake, and then 0.010 and 0.012 for the exhaust. They need to be within those ranges. Now I like to bend them like this to fit a little easier. This one has metric on it, but these aren't angled, except for a couple bent ones. So we're going imperial today. I'll put the metric conversions in the description for the non-US viewers. These two are the intake for cylinder number one. Slide the feeler gauge between the adjusting screw on the rocker arm and the top of the valve stem. And there should be the slightest amount of drag. This is a little too loose. Grab a 10 millimeter wrench, loosen the nut a little, and get a flathead. I like to put the flathead through the wrench and kind of move the feeler gauge around with one hand and adjust the screw with the other hand. Still loose. When there's little resistance, hold the screw in place and tighten the nut. And then check the resistance again to make sure nothing moved. And good. And repeat that for the second intake valve on cylinder number one. This one is also a little loose. Get that resistance just right. A slight drag is what I'm looking for. It shouldn't require much force to slide the feeler gauge out. I forgot to put the box into the wrench around the flathead. Still a little loose. That feels good. And now for the exhaust side. Sometimes the rocker arm is sitting on the valve, so the feeler gauge doesn't slide in. Just pull the rocker arm up with your fingers to allow the gauge to slide in there. And these are on the tight side. Let's back this screw out a little bit. Lift the arm and get that gauge in there. And now I'm just tightening the screw by the feel of the drag on the gauge, just like before. I'm having a hell of a time getting this one just right. And they make a special tool for adjusting these valves. It's like a 10 millimeter wrench and flathead combined into one. It's not expensive. I'll put a link in the description. Might make the job a little easier. So the reason I'm adjusting the valves is because over time the intake valves will wear and tolerance will increase and be too loose. And the exhaust valve tolerance will often decrease and become too tight. I know that sounds weird, but I guess it's from the heat. And these tolerances being off means that the valves aren't opening or closing completely, which reduces the efficiency of the engine. Sometimes the valves can get louder as they get more out of spec. This fit has a rough idle and it even stalled a couple times, so it definitely needs a valve adjustment. And same on this exhaust valve, a little tight. That's good. And cylinder one is done. Now I'm going to rotate clockwise until we get right here. Cylinder number three. And three isn't quite straight up yet. There we go. And I repeated the same steps on the intake and exhaust valves for cylinder three. And after cylinder three is done, I'm gonna rotate the sprocket another quarter turn clockwise until number four is straight up. And then I checked and adjusted the intake and exhaust valves on cylinder number four. And moving on, last but not least, cylinder number two. And tightened up the intake and exhaust valves for cylinder two. I've got some Dupli-Color prep spray. I sprayed some prep spray on a paper towel and cleaned any oil or dirt from the mating surface of the valve cover. Between the timing cover and the cylinder head, there's a little bit of Honda bond that I need to scrape off. Yeah, I heard it hit the ground though. Always a good sound. And the same thing on the front side. And I'm going to replace that with some black RTV. A little dab there. And a little dab there. That was plenty. And just kind of smooth it down a little bit. This helps prevent oil from leaking in those spots where those parts meet. Now it's time to place the new valve cover gasket in the valve cover. Next, I replaced the valve cover bolts, including a couple new ones since two are missing, and torqued them to 8.7 pound-feet. Take these old gaskets off the intake manifold and install the new ones. And same for the throttle body gasket. There's little tabs to make sure they go on the right way. Clean this surface up with a prep spray. Throttle body too, a little dirty. This hole here goes under this bolt. Make that stay up there. And I'm just taking it slow so I don't scrape these new gaskets on anything. Don't forget these metal brackets. Big one goes this way. I'll get some bolts started so nothing moves around. Over here, get this top bolt started. And don't forget about these brackets. And I'm just getting these finger tight for now. Now for that hidden 10 millimeter bolt in the back. Now for this lower bracket. And one, two bolts that go into that. Again, just getting everything finger tight. Then tighten everything last. And plug the IAT sensor back into this janky intake. Reinstall the wheel, put the car to the ground, and done. Now enjoy the regained power and fuel economy of your Honda Fit. Thanks for watching.